What is your favorite instrument? Or what is your favorite piece of equipment?
My favorite piece of music my favorite piece of equipment, believe it or not, is not an instrument. It was a Studer A800 24-track multi-track tape machine.
Okay.
Because whatever you put on that tape machine is like a slot machine. It gave you triple whatever you put into it. Whatever you put on it, it automatically came back better. I used the plug-in version of it, the UAD. It came out in the 70s, but, you know, it was the 90s where it just was, everybody was using it. It's the greatest tape machine ever.
Another Tupac song that you produced is the song Late Night. Do you know, maybe 2 or 3 years ago, Esther Williams sued the Tupac estate because a sample that was used in the song Late Night without her permission?
I don't know. I'm just glad that I don't have to deal with that anymore. I don't use samples as much. Now that I know how to play and arrange, I write my own music now. And it sounds just as good as record music. It's just that sometimes it's fun to get records and sample them because they have a sound. It's that crunchiness. It's that flatness and that you know, that wide harmonic range and distortion and all that makes it good. But I can get that now with just using my using my techniques. And I still got like some of the best recording techniques of any engineer I've ever met. I learned from best and I experimented enough to be able to be totally 100% creative and futuristic. Like, you know, the sound of my records is just different. And this new record that I made, you feel it. It gives you chill bumps. Like, you feel it. It's the emotion jumps right out of the speakers and hits you like rain with no umbrella.
There are two different versions of the song Late Night. One is with you, AMG, and Tupac, and there's another version with Tupac and the Outlaws. Is the version with Tupac, AMG, and you done when Tupac was alive?
It was done when he was alive. We did it all together. We did it in the studio. We did it in Hearts of Men at the same time.
So the version with the Outlaws is done after the version with you, Tupac, and AMG.
Yeah, they changed it up and re-edited it after. You know, the engineers would go in there and just take our master tapes and just re-edit, you know, and do what they wanted to do. The original was me and AMG.
After Tupac passed away, his music is heavily remixed. What is your opinion about this?
Yeah, it's to me, it's like to know Pac was to love him. And when he was alive, all the music was alive. After the posthumous stuff and people just jumping in, like even with 50 Cent, you know what I mean? And all the tricks they were using to, you know, it was like it just became more and more diluted. Like lemonade, you just keep adding water to it. Lemonade and water and water and more water and more water, but no lemons. That's what that's what it kind of felt like to me. It just got really diluted and it got away from where Tupac was really going, you know? Mm-hmm. I would love to see Tupac right now at 43 years old. You know, I'm writing a song about him now where one of the lines is, you know, I was stronger than Tupac. We worked out in the gym. You know, it's a little line because we used to work out together, and every now and then I beat one of our heats or whatever. If we were lifting weights, I could lift a little bit more because I was taller, I guess. I don't know. I was stronger than Pac. We worked out in the gym. But I'd rather be rocking with him than singing his hymns. You know, I'd rather for him to be alive. I think it would be great if he was still around. I wish he could be here.
If there will be a new Tupac album in the future, do you would like to be involved with that?
I mean, if it's really him, and it's a record that you know, if his lyrics are where I'm at right now, then probably so. But if it's not, you know, if it sounds like it's gonna be too controversial, you know, I don't like controversy as much anymore. I don't like to stir up stuff. So, you know, I don't know. I'll probably decline. If it didn't come from the right place, I probably would say no. The remix stuff isn't honest, and it sounds cheap.
There are a lot of rumors that after Tupac passed away, a lot of people stole master tapes and master wheels out of the studio from Death Row. What do you know about this?
Well, I'm not sure if that happened, but I believe that it could have happened. I mean, you know, we used to like to put tapes in that vault. Like, my favorite thing was to to really, you know, itemize the tapes. And when we're done, we'll put them in there, you know, archive. That's what it's all about for me, is about archiving. And I wouldn't be surprised if people went in there and stole tapes, you know, just for memorabilia. I mean, you know, you can't do anything with the used, because the copyright is held by someone else. You know, you can't really sell it to make money, but to steal the tapes and just have them, it'll be more sentimental value. Like, I got this. This is a souvenir. It's just a fucking souvenir, which is really worthless. You know, there's another thing about Tupac. If you could just add this, if there's one thing I like that Tupac, he left me with, he instilled in me, it was to be fearless. Because I used to be, like, nervous all the time. I didn't want anything to happen. I hated, you know, I was, you know, all the gun stuff that used to happen in my neighborhood growing up. After meeting Tupac, it made me fearless. Like, I don't really fear anything anymore, because shit is going to happen anyway, and you can't control it. You can't, why be scared? Don't spend one moment on earth afraid or sorry for anything you've done. Just keep living, because, you know, you can't control fate. Whatever your fate is, it's going to happen. Like, you know, like you said, a hero dies once, a coward dies a thousand deaths. That's the one thing I took from Tupac that I love. And I don't fear any man. I don't fear anything, you know, because we're all going to die anyway. So
yeah.
He made me accept my mortality, you know, and my losses, everything. He made me accept it all.
What is the reason that we only have a few Tupac and DJ Quick songs?
From my opinion?
Yeah.
It's because I was producing a lot of people at that time. I was working with Tony, and, you know, I was trying to become a producer for everyone. You know, Janet Jackson remixes, stuff like that. I wanted to work with everyone. And I didn't have time to do all of this music with Pac. You know, I just didn't, you know, I was busy. I'm an artist too, so I was working on my stuff as well.